Hornet 160R. Frankly speaking, I'm not a very big fan of Honda. But for the first time when I saw this machine in a showroom, I felt a connection. And that connection was so deep that I ended up buying this machine. This machine has been with me for 1.5 years. And I never regretted my decision of buying it. As it is said that no machine is perfect, and my Hornet is no exception.
First of all, quickly let's discuss the cons of this motorcycle. First of all, this tail section of this bike tends to make noise when I ride it through a pothole or a bad road. And also this fairing guard, it also makes some noise.
So the monoshock over here is on a softer side, but it works decently and it is adjustable, so it works for me.
So the gear over here, the gear shifting is not so smooth and sometimes it tends to stuck in the neutral. I think that it could be fixed to servicing because it happens very rarely.
So this is the race adjuster of this bike, and after a period of time you need to adjust this adjust the race repeatedly, because after a certain period of time it get the race get decreased, and I have to again adjust the race, and it is kind of annoying for me.
Even after repeatedly adjusting this LED section, it tends to move upwards, and even I am riding in a low beam, people think that I am in a high beam, and that the light strikes the eye of the riders that are coming from other directions.
This bike has been in the Indian market for a quite long time, and I like the BS4 model the most. The designs, the cuts, everything intrigues me. Though I do not like the indicators of this bike that came stock, so I replaced those indicators with an aftermarket indicator. Apart from that, talking about the pros of this bike, at the time, 2019, it was the most updated bike, and still it feels dated.
Talking about the tires, it has a wide beefy tire, and which helps in controlling the balance when the roads are a bit of sandy, and it helps a lot.
I'm a short rider and my height is 5.3, and the seat height of this bike is 790 mm. So anyone who is a short rider could manage this bike. As you can see that I am tiptoeing in this bike, so as long as you are tiptoeing, you can manage this bike. So it is a good bike for a short rider too.
As I said that this bike is dated, though it is from 2019, but if you buy this bike you will feel that it is up to date because of this ABS. It is ABS standard as a dual channel. It is a dual channel ABS and it works well. In many instances it has saved me from an accident by not locking the brakes. So this ABS and the brakes of this bike works decently. So
it is 2020 and you have more options to buy a bike. You have NS200, you have R15 V3, you have 160 4V. So this bike creates more torque, more power than this bike. So why should you buy this bike now? That's the main question.
It is a balanced bike. It gives a mileage of 40 to 45. This bike is not underpowered. It has a linear power delivery and it will not scare the hell out of you.
Because of the weight distribution of this bike, you will find it fun to ride it in the highways. And plus the electronics of this bike is very up to date.